Hello, Internet. Welcome back to our Learning Azure ML series. Today we will cover accessing Azure ML, importing data into Azure ML, and creating an experiment. If you already know how to do those things, just go ahead and skip to the next video in the series. So how do you access Microsoft Azure ML? Well, Azure ML is a web application within Microsoft Azure itself. So I have Microsoft Azure open, and you just click on and access your portal into Microsoft Azure. And it should be one of the Azure services that pops up on the left side, right? So it's actually represented as a beacon. That's kind of cute. So you click on the machine learning, and then access your account, and then sign into the ML Studio. So now we're actually in Microsoft Azure Machine Learning itself, and this is where all of our experiments are kept. And as you can see, we already have a whole bunch of experiments running. All right, now that we have access to Azure ML, let's import some data into Azure ML. So before we can import data, we have to get data from an external source. And today we'll be using the Titanic Data Set. It's a very well-known introductory data set. And I'm going to get it from the Kaggle website, because Kaggle is actually hosting a data mining competition right now on the Titanic Data Set. You can enter it if you want. And we're going to actually download the Titanic Training Data Set CSV file. You won't need a Kaggle account though, but if you don't want to do that, you can just Google Titanic CSV and a whole bunch of hits should come up. Alright, so once you have that file downloaded, let's just take a peek inside and see what's in there. So, alright, good. So this is a CSV file. It's a flat file meant for transferring a lot of data via text. So now that we actually have data to import into Azure ML, let's do that. So on the bottom left-hand corner of Azure ML, there is a new button. You want to click on that button and go to dataset and go to local file, and then this is where you get to choose your file, right? So let's import the Titanic CSV. And because I've already imported the Titanic CSV earlier, it asked me if I want to replace the new dataset. So this is really handy, right? If you decide that you want to add more data in the future, or like if you have an ongoing file that you want to import. And these are all the file types that are supported by Azure ML. Now, also please note that if you're trying to import a spreadsheet, you can just simply import it as a CSV file. That'll be fine. It will read the XLS just fine. And then you want to hit this checkbox when you're done. All right, so we have our data, and it's somewhere in the Azure Machine Learning Studio. So let's click on the new button again, and let's create a new experiment. And that'll take us to our workspace, where we can actually start building our experiments. Now we're actually in the Machine Learning Studio. Let's name our experiments, right? So we can have multiple experiments, huge amounts of experiments, actually. And let's call this Titanic model, all right? So then you'll notice in the background, there's a template of how things should look, right? So you have your data, it goes in, it's going into data transformation. Then you have experiment one, experiment two, scoring, validation, etc. So let's go look for our Titanic data that we've imported. So look at this here. So this is all the data that we have access to, right? So there's a whole bunch of sample data that comes is shipped with Azure Machine Learning. And for example, you can just double click to bring the Titanic data set in, or you can drag it in, right? And it will remind you kind of like Visio. Well, that concludes our video. Join us next time when we'll show you how to import non-static data files and data from various external sources.
If you like what you just saw, subscribe to our channel or leave us a comment. Let us know if there's a topic you want us to cover, and be sure to check us out at datasciencedojo.com. Until next time.